Ed Hussein, som i 5 år var aktiv islamist, men som senere dannet den ekstremismebekjempende tenketanken Quilliam Foundation, sammen med Majib Nawaz, har den 22. august i år skrevet en meget god artikkel i New York Times om Saudi-Arabias ekstremismeeksport. Han skriver blant annet: "Along with a billion Muslims across the globe, I turn to Mecca in Saudi Arabia every day to say my prayers. But when I visit the holy sites of Mecca and Medina, the resting place of the Prophet Muhammad, I'm forced to leave overwhelmed with anguish at the power of extremism running amok in Islam's birthplace. Non-Muslims are forbidden to enter this part of the kingdom, so there is no international scrutiny of the ideas and practices that affect the 13 million Muslims who visit each year." Hussein sier videre: "Let's be clear, Al-Qaeda, the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria, Boko Haram, the Shabab, and others are all violent Sunni Salafi groupings. For 5 decades, Saudi Arabia has been the official sponsor of Sunni Salafism across the globe. Unlike a majority of Sunnis, Salafis are evangelicals who wish to convert Muslims and others to the purer form of Islam, unpolluted as they see it by modernity. In this effort, they have been lavishly supported by the Saudi government, which has appointed missionaries to its embassies in Muslim countries who proselytize for Salafism. We are rightly outraged at the beheading of James Foley by Islamist militants and by ISIS other atrocities, but we overlook the public executions by beheading permitted by Saudi Arabia. By licensing such barbarity, the kingdom normalizes and indirectly encourages such punishments elsewhere. When the country that does so is the birthplace of Islam, that message resonates. Textbooks in Saudi Arabia's schools and universities teach this brand of Islam. The University of Medina recruits students from around the world, train them in the bigotry of Salafism, and sends them to Muslim communities in places like the Balkans, Africa, Indonesia, Bangladesh, and Egypt, where these Saudi-trained hardliners work to eradicate the local harmonic forms of Islam. Saudi Arabia creates the monster that is Salafi terrorism. It cannot now outsource the slaying of its beast to the United Nations. It must address the theological and ideological roots of extremism at home, starting in Mecca and Medina. Reforming the home of Islam would be a giant step forward toward winning against extremism in the global battle of ideas. Ed Hussein avslører i denne artikkelen kjernen i det islamistiske problemkomplekset, den totalitære ideologien som wahhabismen og salafismen bygger på, og det utviklingsforløpet for mange unge fundamentalister er først en grundig skolering i den totalitære ideologien, en eksersis som etter hvert fører til et brennende ønske om konkret handling som kan forandre verden. Det er en skam og en totalt uforståelig at Vesten i det hele tatt samarbeider med Saudi-Arabia. Som en kuriositet, noen ganger på 70-tallet på vei til Tanzania, innebar flyturen en mellomlanding i Saudi-Arabia. Før landing ba flyvertiden oss å gjemme unna alle alkoholholdige drikkevarer når det lokale rengjøringspersonalet gjorde sin ankomst. Jeg lovte meg selv en gang at jeg aldri skulle sette mitt fot i dette drittlandet, naturligvis av andre årsaker enn alkohol. Det løftet har jeg holdt, og det løftet skal jeg holde.